Welcome back to a new series. In this episode, episode 2, we're gonna show you how to mix drums. Enjoy.
So, what I like to do is EQ and compress and all those things.
Yeah.
I like to do it in context and not focusing so much on soloing specific instruments. Soloing for me is very, very useful when you're finding problems.
Okay.
Not so much when you're determining whether you like the feel and the taste of the drum sound, because it all comes together and depends on one another.
Yeah.
So if your kick drum smacks and tears walls down, but everything else is just bombed away by that, then you might have a very cool kick, but the rest is shitty. So don't do that. So I will do just a few adjustments, do it quick, and then we move on. What I have to do is actually now take my trusty headphones and listen on them, because with the small speakers that we have here in the studio, you actually can't really tell the difference in the low-end department. So I'll go with these. Ah, nice. What I'm trying to do is give it a little booty, just a little 60-ish hertz, roll off a little bit of that lower mid-range thing where
bass
and guitar live, and the kick has not very much beautiful things to give, to put it politely. And then because you lose the mid-range, where our hearing best functions.
Yeah.
And of course, because many people listen on systems that don't produce very much low end, you need to emphasize it a little bit back in a realm where it fits. And a good starting point is 2K-ish, 2.5, maybe a little lower, maybe a little higher. The metal guys don't even do it up to 7, 8K and want it really clicky. It's all a matter of taste. So just what feels good. What I did here is give it a little booty, scoop it a little out, and make it hearable again. That's that. And because we are shelving, I like to put a little bit of low cut there, just around, well, maybe 40 hertz, because when you boost so much low end, you get a lot of trash. Nothing can reproduce it. No PA on the planet reproduces 10 hertz, and you actually want it. So what that does is it messes with your compression afterwards, because the signal is going in the whole chain, and you don't really hear it, you don't really want to hear it, but it messes with everything that comes after. So just get rid of it, and you're good to go. So we have a little 40 hertz cut, and that's that, actually. So, same thing, snare drum. You can hear it. The tone and the weight of the snare is around 200 and a bit. Classic Neve EQs have their golden snare, for me, the golden snare band at 220 hertz. So that's always a good starting point when you take those old EQs and look mm-hmm. where they put their points, because they did it on with thought. Yeah, they did it with purpose. And why not use this knowledge?
Yeah.
Now I'm trying to hear how high I can get without losing too much. Because again, I don't want
any trash.
Trash. You have to be careful. If you high pass everything mm-hmm. Or low cut and you do it automatically, sometimes the energy and the glue gets lost a little bit, okay, so be careful with that. But with elements in the mix that I want to process and compress and do reverb on and stuff like that, I always try to control it as good as possible. Mm-hmm. So we did a little shimmer, made it a little brighter, mm-hmm. And we give it a little weight and bottom. And then we control the bottom end a little bit. And then let's have a listen what that gives us. That is out. That is in. It's not much, but it is a little more exciting and little your ear is drawn to it a little bit more. What I like to do is go into the channel strip, pick myself a saturation, drive it up a little, and you hear how it made it the whole snare a little beefier.
Yeah,
that's all it does. When you put up the high end on a snare or on any particular source, a good way to round it off a little bit and to make it not so piercing is just saturate it. Put it through tape, put it through distortion. Not too audible. With a snare you can actually be quite aggressive. Mm-hmm. But catch it a little bit, and then you have the brightness and excitement is still there, but it just doesn't pierce your ear as much. So that's all that I would do to the snare for now. Maybe I'll come back and compress it a little. But we will see. When I feel that my snare is getting lost, mm-hmm. because I want it hefty and energetic.